there are different ways to design a vaccine. The Moderna and Pfizer mRNA vaccines use a strategy whereby in the vaccine they deliver an instruction or a code, and that gets delivered inside our cells, and then our own cells are instructed to make a piece of the virus that elicits an immune response. With the Novavax vaccine, it's a protein-based vaccine, which is a much more traditional vaccine. There are several vaccines that are approved and used in the United States for various infections and have been so for decades. With this strategy of a vaccine, the vaccine itself delivers the piece of the COVID-19 virus that we want to elicit the immune response to. So it's the same spike protein that is eliciting a response with the other COVID-19 vaccines, but in this case, it's being delivered directly in the vaccine. The results were really quite promising and released some time ago. The Novavax vaccine was 90.4% effective in preventing symptomatic COVID-19 illness. The data that's been submitted to the FDA covers a certain amount of time, including when the Delta variant was circulating, and much less so with the Omicron variant. In addition to the data we have from this phase 3 study, they have done additional analysis to test the vaccine against the Omicron variant in a lab, for example, and looking at immune responses and what's more important, neutralizing responses. There is some eliciting immune responses to the Omicron variant. It's less compared to the protection or the responses we saw with the initial Wuhan strain and the other variants. They also looked at responses after getting a booster dose, which was provided through this phase 3 study, and saw that the responses to the Omicron increased quite nicely. UNC was a site for the phase 3 study of the Novavax vaccine. It is a 2-year study, so our site, like the others, are continuing to follow the participants who enrolled for any safety issues and for additional immunological testing. In addition, UNC was the site where we enrolled adolescents, so adolescents ages from age 12 to 17, who we are also continuing to follow on the study and will be followed for up to 2 years. In the United States, given where we are with vaccination rates, it's most likely that the Novavax vaccine, if approved for EUA, Novavax plans to submit for EUA approval to use as a booster. So in the United States, it's more likely that the Novavax vaccine would be used as a booster dose. However, this EUA submission and approval would be for primary series. There are many of us that are hopeful that some individuals who remain unvaccinated, given some concerns with, what they see as sort of newer vaccine strategies with the mRNA vaccines, would be willing to get a more traditional approach to vaccines. So for those who remain unvaccinated and are willing to try this vaccine, it would be great. The vaccine is already approved in several other countries, including the European Union. It has been cleared by the World Health Organization. So it is being administered for primary series in many settings. One of the key advantages of the Novavax vaccine is that it does not have to be frozen. So storage and the logistics of delivering this vaccine in rural or in low resource countries would be much, much easier. So in many ways, it makes it a much more accessible vaccine once it becomes more widely available, and including in the United States, which does have a lot of rural, semi-rural settings where having the freezers that are needed and transportation of the vaccines is an issue.